The Monty Hall Problem is a probability puzzle named after Monty Hall, the original host of the US TV show Let's Make a Deal. It's a famous paradox with a solution that is so absurd that most people refuse to believe it's true. Suppose you are on a game show and you're given the choice of three doors. Behind one door is a car, behind the others, goats. You pick a door, say door number one, and the host who knows what's behind the doors will open door number three, which will have a goat. He then asks you, do you want to switch your option to door number two? Should you do it? Is it to your advantage to switch your choice? What do you think? Please pause here and think about the problem. The answer is yes, you should change, and this is very counterintuitive, but that is what you should do. When you pick your initial door, you have a 33% chance of winning, 1 out of 3. Then the presenter chooses a door for you that has a goat. You may think now that you have a 50% chance of winning with only 2 doors left, but that is not true. You only have 33% probability of winning, while switching gives you 67%. The secret here is the curated choice, because the presenter knows what's inside the doors and he picks one that has the goat. I'll admit that this is very counterintuitive. And for me, the easiest way to understand is by going through all possibilities. Imagine that you pick door A. There are 3 possibilities for the car, since it can be inside doors A, B, or C. The first scenario is that the prediction is correct, and the car is inside door A. The presenter will hide doors B or C, since they'll have the goats. And if you don't switch, you win. And if you switch, you lose. So we have one victory for door A. The next option is picking door A and the car being inside door B. The presenter will hide door C. You will win if you switch. And now our scenarios are tied. One victory for not switching and then one victory for switching. The other option is picking door A and the car being inside door C. The presenter will hide door B because it has a goat. If you switch, you will win. And if you don't switch, you will lose. We have done all possibilities now for picking door A, and switching yields 2 victories, while not switching only offers 1 victory. Now, this really may seem like dark magic to you, so let's imagine you pick door B. Let's do another round. If the car is inside door A, the presenter will hide door C. If you switch, you win. If the car is inside door B, the presenter will hide either doors A or C, and you win only if you don't switch. Lastly, if the car is inside door C, the presenter will hide door A because it will have a goat, and you switch, or better yet, you win only if you switch. Once more, switching gives you 2 wins, while not changing gives you only 1. Hopefully, I have done a good job explaining, but this exercise is not trivial at all. The problem was put in a magazine in 1975, similar to how I shared it with you. Then the magazine shared the solution and educated mathematicians and statisticians sent letters complaining about the solution, saying that it was wrong, here are some examples. From Robert Sachs, a PhD, he replied, "As a professional mathematician, I am very concerned with the general public's lack of mathematical skills. Please help by confessing your error and in the future being more careful." Scott Smith, also PhD, "You blew it, and you blew it big. Since you seem to have difficulty grasping the basic principle at work here, I'll explain." And then the last one is from Barry Pasternak, also PhD, and he answers, and I quote, "Your answer to the question is wrong, but if it is in any consolation, many of my academic colleagues have also been stumped by this problem." The bottom line is that statistics can be complex and counterintuitive. Sometimes you need to explore the data and have frameworks on your mind to tackle these problems. This is my main goal for the course, to give you the tools to overcome bias and to find better solutions. Until the next video, have fun!